Hello, and thank you for your interest in PhishER. This is KnowBefore's platform for working with messages reported by end users as they become trained and more familiar with spotting threats in their inbox. This is a fully hosted platform, so everything you see here is in the cloud, and what you're looking at right now is the dashboard. This is a quick overview of messages that have come in over time, what those messages have been dispositioned as, clean, spam, or threat, and the priority that these messages have been given, anything from low to critical. You'll also see how many of these messages have been automatically resolved. And this is really your big time saver. And that's the whole purpose of this platform. We want to save you time and we want to make it easier for you to identify and disposition messages as they come in. And we're going to do that by jumping straight into the inbox. It's an inbox, everybody's seen it, but we bring you a little bit more information. We've got a tags column here, and these tags are there to tell you a little bit about the message before you even start drilling in. We have a message here, for example, has the PML threat tag. This tells me that PhishML, our machine learning module, has decided that this message is a threat. We have VTBad that tells me VirusTotal has found something that it doesn't like in there. And a custom tag called invoice, and that tells me that somewhere in this message it says the word invoice. I think it's right there in the subject. And now that we're in the message, we can very quickly see what the message is, jump right over into the raw parts of the message, check the header for standard or non-standard headers. If we've got something in particular we're looking for, we can check it right there. Any attachments will be automatically scanned if you bring your own key. And we know that this one's already bad. Good job not paying this invoice. Any URLs will also be automatically scanned. And if they've been shortened by any way, you can also unwind them here automatically. The match rules will show here, and that's that custom rule that we talked about. And we can see a full audit log of everything that's happened to this message. So anyone in your SOC, your InfoSec team can come in here and quickly analyze that message and disposition it. It's threat, it's resolved, it's high priority. But then to take it one step farther, we can also
initiate a PhishRIP query to find similar messages
by whatever criteria you've set. In this case, let's say find everything from this gentleman that has the word new invoice and find it within the last few days and automatically quarantine everything. This is going to go through your entire O365 organization and automatically quarantine any messages that fit this criteria throughout your entire organization. Now that this one's done, we can go on to the next one. And we can do the same thing and manually disposition each one, but that's one at a time. How do we really save time? Well, if we come over here to rooms, we can get a quick grouping by subject, sender, URL, attachment names, or any other saved query that we like. And we saw that new invoice right there. It turns out that we were looking at only one of six. So since we've already done our research, we can come in here and just bulk disposition all of these. But if we look, we see that we've gotten this message six times in the past week. Odds are this guy's going to send us those messages again as time goes on. How do we protect ourselves for the future and not just look in the past? Well, we can build rules. That invoice rule that we were looking at simply looks for the word invoice in it, but it brings us that little bit of information right at the beginning. We've also got rules that check to see if someone is posing as our CEO. You can do all sorts of things with Yara, and what that will do is add tags to those messages so we see them on the inbox, and that gives us that little bit more information before we get into the message. But where it really gets good is right over here in actions. From those tags, we can come in and say, all right, if we see that CEO fraud tag, automatically disposition this message. Set it to interview, set it to priority high, set it to a category of a threat, and automatically dump this out to our syslog, or to our sim through syslog. If it was a spam, maybe I send a message back to the original reporter and say, hey, please stop sending spam. For your example, for your information, this is what we want you to use the PhishAlert button for. Or maybe if it's a threat, I'm also going to send it out to my InfoSec team, attach an original of the message, and maybe include links back to PhishER. The rules and the actions is really your 1-2 combo to really save time. But as time goes on, you'll also get some really good information from the reports. find out which of your users are using that phish alert button to just get rid of their spam, or maybe they're sending a whole lot of threats. And you can build more rules to automatically prioritize those messages higher or lower. So as a quick overview, see what messages are coming in, automatically start getting that information from the inbox, get some quick information from PhishML, get some quick information from VirusTotal. Once you've found those threats, automatically rip them out of inboxes over your entire organization with PhishRIP and automate away a lot of your work. Give yourself time to focus on those threats. And that's it for this brief intro. If you'd like to know more, please schedule some time for your own one-on-one demo where a sales rep can take you through the entire PhishER platform at more depth. Thanks. Have a good day.